We're looking crusty today. My God. Good morning, you guys. Welcome to the final vlog. It is Sunday. I think it's like noon right now, if not 12:30. As you can tell by the energy levels in these vlogs, we are significantly more tired, but super excited. It's our last day today, which is absolutely crazy. I feel like I've been at this festival for literally forever. But right now we're gonna go hit up the showers, see what the shower situation is, because I haven't showered in like 2 days. Showers cost $10. They're really nice, like mobile showers. We just ate. I just got this amazing like barbecue chicken mac and cheese grilled cheese, which was fantastic. Really needed a coffee, but the coffee lines are like fucking insane here. Today is beautiful weather, just super windy. I've got this adorable outfit I'm excited to wear. We've got our meetup. Me and Aid are hosting a meetup today. And then other than that, it's like super chill vibes. I don't think I have anybody that I'm like dying to see today. I think there's like Eli and Fur, Shiba-san, Wuki, and I'm honestly not even sure who else is today. So it's gonna be a good day. We're gonna make the most of it. I wanna go explore the forest, see everything we didn't see so far. Yeah, and I'll take you guys along for the ride.
What is happening here?
This was Marin's surprise for me.
Oh my God. All right, fam. I feel like this is where I check in every single day, but we're ready. Last day, day four. I'll have to show you the whole fit, but we're finally wearing my Dios Abiseco, which I bought this million years ago and I haven't worn it yet, but it's probably the most fabulous thing I've ever put on my body. So I've got the little hair, makeup done, and we're going straight in and going straight to our meetup today. So you guys will see that.
Thank you.
every gift under the fucking sun. Now she got a vampire duck.
She got her cotton candy.
How we feeling, guys?
Great. We fucking, this festival is the fucking best. I swear to God. The cops are amazing here. There's a cop walking around with a finger puppet on, just high-fiving people. Like, genuinely the best vibes, like, physically possible.
This is amazing. Yeah, oh, it has a candy on it. I have to do whatever it says.
You have to do whatever I interpret that it says.
Great, let's do it.
Let's go.
I've never been more excited.
Oh, man, I'm so excited.
Do it.
What's she gonna get?
It's a trick. It's never actually gonna stop spinning.
You're gonna get something good. Ooh. If it landed on Spank Me.
Big fall. No. The rule of this game is you're gonna have to go around there and fake a fall in front of someone, but make it convincing enough that they feel like they actually have to help you.
No!
Right?
Make them help you.
Okay.
Go trip.
Get our friends to hold your shit.
Noted. Oh shit. Oh. Are you okay?
Oh, she's alright.
She's kidding! We're kidding. It was a joke.
The tighter the better.
There we go.
Literally. No end.
Happy Forest. Happy Forest. Happy Forest.
Kermit switch channels.
Screaming.
Seven lions.
What? Someone's
seven
screaming
lions.
In
mine right now.
Yeah.
So we were at a house music set at Tripoli on Sunday, and we were maybe there for a couple minutes. Like, we had just gotten there, and I don't remember like exactly how it happened, but I just remember a woman, we were all the way front left, like almost against the railing, front left. There wasn't that many people there on that side either, but this woman turns around and says, "Medic, medic, medic," like starts screaming for a medic, and we're like, "What do you need?" And then all of a sudden I see this man like drop to the ground, literally blue. Like, I thought he was dead. It was horrifying, and we're like, fuck. Our entire friend group and everyone around us starts screaming for Narcan, because you can administer Narcan to somebody who's experiencing an overdose to revive them. So my whole group starts asking like around us, does anyone have Narcan, like freaking out. In that instant, it was like fight or flight. I just fucking sprinted to the medical tent, which is why I'm going to share the story, is because you need to know where the medical tents are at festivals, guys. Like, you absolutely need to know, because you never know when you're going to be in this situation. So I knew that there was a medical tent at the very back of Tripoli. It wasn't far at all. It was literally right in the back, dead center. So when I saw him hit the ground, I sprinted to the medical tent, and I would like just ran up to the guys, and I was like, there's a man on the ground, not breathing. And they just popped up and sprinted back with me. We literally just stood there like watching in horror. Like, I thought this man was dead. It was like literally traumatizing. A couple minutes later, another one of their friends drops to the ground. Second guy drops to the ground. The medical team, at this point, cops and more medical staff came over. They started administering CPR and chest compressions on the second person. I've never witnessed that in person before at an event. It was literally traumatizing. They ended up getting carted away. They put them on carts and carted them away. But the whole rest of the night, we were just like, what the fuck? Like, I don't know what happened to them. I don't know if they're alive. I don't even know what we just witnessed. I was hysterically crying. A lot of us were crying. Like, it was just very traumatizing to witness. So that was very, very scary. We did decide to regroup and sit there because I was ready to leave. I was like, I want to go to the tent. Like, I was hysterical, and we were just like, we can't leave the festival on this note. Like, let's just take a breather. Like, let's just all sit together, because a lot of us still were together. So we just like sat on the floor. We watched Air to Earth, which was Porter Robinson's set, and luckily like decompressed and like we're breathing and things like that. I'm happy to report, I went on Reddit after the festival. Somebody posted about this event, like, did anybody see what happened? Does anyone know what happened to the people at Tripoli? As far as I know, there were no reported deaths at Electric Forest. And in the Reddit, people responded that they are alive. So I just had to say that. I don't mean to end this, like, on a negative note. Like, this is not a reflection of Electric Forest or anything like that. It's just an experience that I had at the end of the festival. It did not ruin the experience for me or what I think of this event or anything like that. It's just, like, to me, and my friend Aid was there too, and she said like we were there for a reason, and hopefully it's to talk about this experience so that this doesn't happen to somebody else, is kind of how I feel, like why we were there.
Guys, we're out of here. literally, we're just the most crusty, but that was cute. packed everything up, it's noon right now, the lines are absolutely insane. I'll show you guys what it's like to get out, but like, yeah, it just took a while. I have some stories to tell you about last night that will all be in the review and everything, but I'll show you the line going out. Right now, what we're doing is our flight was canceled. Thanks United for that. So we ended up rebooking with American Airlines out of Chicago. So luckily our friends are amazing. They have an RV and they're driving to Chicago. So we're gonna go meet them at Grand Rapids Airport, drop this car off, and then hop in their RV, go to Chicago, and then we still get home like just later tonight, which is still really good. So we're gonna make it home. It's all good. We had the best fucking time. Here be the lines everywhere. Favorite festival. Would you come back?
Oh yeah.
That was cool. Yeah. Eric and Tara drank 5 beatboxes each yesterday. So we're feeling a little rough today, but yeah. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Fall into you.